Bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien, j'espère que tout va bien chez vous. Alors, comme d'habitude, je vais essayer de vous dire bonjour à tout le monde. So I'm going to say hello to everybody, so let's give me the time to look at the names. Alors, qui est là? Rita Assor est là, bonjour Rita. Rosalia est avec nous, Curiosidades est là, Yossi est là. Victoria Jacques aussi, Victoria Posse également. Je suis Lani est là, Bikert est là, Sapna est là, Barty est là, Mujahid est là, ensuite Arkitoun est là, Pop Viet Musique est là, Mr. Peter est là, Maria Bethania aussi, Stéphanie, Save the Best, Omar, Yvette, oh là là, mais il y a beaucoup, beaucoup de monde. Bah écoutez, j'espère que vous allez bien, so I hope that everything is going fine for you. Ice Cube is joining us. So we'll start, well, with the first category that we have. I mean, the usual one. Ah, yeah. You know that I want to bug you since the beginning of the series, but this is the way it will go. So remember that I have been starting this new series last week. So the concept is quite simple. First, you will record yourself with your phone, so it can be video. I prefer video because it's more interactive, and then I will show my face too, so everyone participate. But if you prefer audio, it's totally okay, no problem. So you will have to pronounce a sentence, a phrase. So after that, you send me your audio and video file to pronounce at fluent2plus.com. And then I will make a compilation of the clips, and then I will give you some advices how to make sure that you can pronounce perfectly this French sentence. And the phrase of the week, la phrase de la semaine, it's a tricky one because it involves some subjonctif. And then to pronounce, because I wanted to make sure that it would be a bit challenging. So the sentence is, nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant. Nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant. So you record yourself, you send that to me, and then after that I will have some fun with it. Don't worry, I'm extremely, it will be positive. I'm not here to criticize, I'm here to help you, and well, that's it. Merci beaucoup in advance. And so the question of the day is the following. Alors, as some of you might know, I have a son. My son is Nicolas, and he's the one who is usually playing the games while I'm doing some comments in French. So Nicolas will be tomorrow 11 years old, so il aura 11 ans. So give me some good ideas of gifts that I could make to Nicolas. Quel cadeau je devrais faire à mon fils Nicolas pour ses 11 ans? So try to remember when you were 11. Allez, une petite minute, you've got 1 minute to give me some tips. Merci. Alors, the idea is to make some sentences. Borger qui dit un iPhone 12. Barty qui dit une PS4. I Just Called qui dit une PlayStation 5. Mr. PD qui dit PS5. Oui, mais il faut faire des phrases, s'il vous plaît. You should make some sentences. This is the idea. One sentence to answer. Dorger qui dit FIFA 21. Looney qui dit de l'argent, ok, L apostrophe, remember, you should put the apostrophe. Isis Vera, vous pouvez offrir un jeu vidéo comme Animal Crossing. Ina qui dit un skateboard. Stéphanie qui dit lui acheter un vélo. Looney qui répète encore l'argent, mais avec l'apostrophe. Merci Looney. Victoria Jacques qui dit les temps sont différents de quand j'avais 11 ans. Peut-être un nouveau système de jeu. Ice Cubes, est-ce qu'il aime les Lego? Peut-être un beau cadeau. Curiosidades, un dragon ou un jeu vidéo? Passang, je pense que vous pouvez donner... Nintendo Switch, d'accord. Boomville Lover, des vacances à Disneyland, oui. Mais c'est un petit peu, c'est pas une bonne période pour voyager, mais c'est une très bonne idée. It's a good idea, it's not the best time in the year to travel with the COVID and everything, but I think it could be a good idea. Yossi, un cadeau qui lui paiera le plus. Sapna, tout d'abord, un grand bisou à Nicolas. Il met le cadeau, je ne sais pas, désolé. C'est pas grave. Un bisou, c'est pas mal. Kajal. Vous pouvez offrir quelque chose qu'il aime et veut depuis longtemps. Bickert, vous pouvez faire trop embrasser et vous pouvez lui dire que vous l'aimez. Bah yeah, Bickert, but I'm doing that every day. A hugs and a kisses and I love you. C'est classique. Omar, le meilleur cadeau que vous puissiez lui faire est le cadeau d'amour de père en fils. C'est vrai, c'est vrai. Ina, a-t-il un souhait? Non, c'est ça le problème. Rajni, des livres pour lire et j'espère qu'il les aimera. Merci Rajni. Je suis Lani, vous pouvez lui donner le petit Larousse. Très bonne idée. Pop, musique, Viette, je pense qu'un chien serait un beau cadeau. Ah oui, mais un chien, après, c'est toujours la responsabilité des parents. Et là, c'est juste ma responsabilité, donc. Victoria Possé, vous pouvez lui offrir un livre et un gros bisou. Save the best qui dit, Poppy, oh non, same thing, you know, this is, after that, it's not the children, it will be me. I will have to go out every time with the dog. Rita, vous achetez un abonnement à Venise pour apprendre le français. D'accord. Moujahid, vous pouvez lui acheter Jazet de l'équipe de France. Griezmann, ah oui, vous voulez dire un t-shirt. Maria Betania, je pense que vous pouvez lui donner quelques livres. Well, thank you very much. It was really, really nice. And I will try to get inspired with your suggestion. Merci. Alors, la prochaine, so the next exercise, it's how would you translate? We've been doing that several times, so normally it should not be a big problem. You just need to remember one thing. In these sentences, I am expecting you to use futur simple. So we agree, this is the concept. I give you the translation, then you've got to find the correct phrase in French, but then use le futur simple. So let's try to see if we will succeed together. And we start with the first one. And the first one, look, I'll come and see her tomorrow. I will come and see her tomorrow. How could you translate that into French? And remember, I'm expecting futur simple. Merci beaucoup. So you can start now. Alors, I'm looking at all your answers because they start to come. So my version was well, a simple one. So basically, venir in the future, futur simple. So je viendrai, and then I just wanted to put right after the verb voir. Obviously, the pronoun, pronom complément d'objet direct, hein, before. Je viendrai là. Voir, and then demain. So, be careful, Kajal, you've been saying je viendrai lui voir. Non, it must be la voir, hein, because we saw that before. Voir, it will be constructed in that case with a complément d'objet direct. Hein. So it means that you have to use the pronoun complément d'objet direct. And in that situation, third person, it would be whether le for the masculine or then la for the feminine. So, je viendrai la voir demain. Demain could be in the first place. Demain, je viendrai la voir. We agree. It's not a problem in that case. So, let's have a look now at the second one. And the second one is, he won't tell her. He won't tell her, so could you please translate that into French, keeping in mind that, of course, I'm expecting futur simple. Alors, I can see that you've got your versions coming, so let's have a look at that. So, in most of the cases, it's quite good. Be careful, Rory, you've been putting this conditionnel présent. So, in that situation, I wanted to use the verb dire, hein, dire, to say, in the future simple form. So, dira, D-I-R-A. Then we put the negation, so the negative form, il ne dira pas. And then I wanted to squeeze here before the pronoun, because the pronoun should be complément d'objet indirect, so it will be lui. Remember that it's interesting, when it's pronom complément d'objet indirect, whether it's masculine or feminine, it will be always lui. So, il ne lui dira pas. It could be translated by he won't tell him or he won't tell her. Because in French, this lui will stand for the masculine and the feminine. Il ne lui dira pas. The reason that we, in fact, don't really need to define whether it's masculine or feminine here, it's one explanation, but it's because there are pronouns, and the pronouns, by definition, they replace something that was mentioned before. So normally you know exactly before using it if it's a man or a woman. So that's the reason why this lui, in fact, just give you the information that it's the third person of the singular, but then you know exactly if you're talking about a man or a woman. Let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, we won't be going on vacation this summer. We won't be going on vacation this summer. Could you please translate that into French and put, please, futur simple? Alors, I can see that Ashley is back and he's the first one, but unfortunately, Ashley, alors Ashley, remember that été is masculine. And so, yeah, it's starting with a vowel, so basically, phonetically, you were good. You were good, so it's set, okay, but keep in mind that because it's masculine, you will write it C-E-T, d'accord? So you went for on. I wanted to go for nous, just to make it a bit more rich in a way and a bit more classical. But if you want to go for nous, it's totally okay. You will have to conjugate it at the third person of the singular. So no problem about that. But if you want to go for nous like I did, then the verb aller, it's ir for the root. You put your ending ons, nous. Irons. And then we put the negative form, nous n'irons pas, then en vacances cet été. Allez, on continue, numéro 4. Regardez, numéro 4, eh bien, she will be lucky. She will be lucky, how can you translate that into French? And of course, I am hoping for futur simple. Alors, Pasang is the first one to answer, but then you've been missing, you've been forgetting the verb. So the expression, it's avoir de la chance. Avoir de la chance, it's to be lucky. So it's interesting because for us, we will say like to have luck, avoir de la chance. So, of course, I wanted to use avoir because avoir, it's a tricky one. When you have to put that in the futur simple, the root will change. As you can see, it will be A-U-R, or. Then you will add your ending, and the ending for L, it will be A-L-O-R-A, and then the rest continue, de la chance. Elle aura de la chance. So I was looking at the thing. So everyone wanted to go to this with this one. So it's good. So avoir de la chance. Rajni went for the adjective chanceuse with être, which is totally possible. Rajni. Rajni, it was good. In most of the cases, we would go for avoir de la chance. It's the expression that normally we use, but it was totally correct what you wrote. Let's look at number 5. Alors, attention, numéro 5, they will be home tonight. Same thing here, please, could you write me the translation into French and keep in mind that I am hoping to see a beautiful futur simple. Alors, I can see that it's arriving quite fast. Oops, look, I've got a beautiful typo here. And this is the beauty about doing that live, because I can correct right away. So, il, with the S. And then, of course, the idea is to use the verb être. Verb être, remember, it's a tricky one, because when You will put that in the future simple, then it means that the root will be totally different. The root will be sœur, S-E-R. And then you put your ending, O-N-T. Ils seront, and I wanted you to go for the chez, because chez, it's usually something that we use a lot. So, ils seront chez, and then you put these, les pronoms toniques, eux. Ils seront chez eux. Ok? Donc, ils seront chez eux ce soir. Rory is asking, il with a S, oui Rory. I've been correcting that straight, monsieur. This is the way I do it. Efficient. Allez, ils seront chez eux ce soir. Well, let's go with the next one now. Okay, and for this one, it's the three nouns of the day. Remember, I will give you a picture, and this is the picture that you can see. And please try to find three nouns. I'm talking about nouns. I don't want verbs. I don't want adjectives. I don't want adverbs. I want nouns. And obviously, if you write the nouns, I'm expecting you to put the article to know if it's masculine or feminine, or eventually plural or two. D'accord? So three nouns related to the picture that you see right now. Alors, Mr. Peter is the first one to write. Le phare, la promenade, les gens. Rory, un homme, une femme, les gens. Sundar, marché. Yeah, I didn't want any adverbs, any verbs, sorry. Oui, Sundar has been deleting. Ankan, le pont, la tour, le mec. So, be careful with le mec. It's spoken French, so it's really informal. Don't use that with everybody. Okay, you need to be aware about that. Pradip, la tour, féminin, l'homme, la femme. Sapna, la longue rue, deux couples, une image. Ina, les gens, la lumière et le sac. Rajni, un couple marié, une promenade, l'amour. Yossi, un pont, un homme, un couple. Kajal, les monuments, l'homme et la femme, la, est-ce que c'est la rue? Sandra Walsh, une femme, un homme, une rue. Passang, des couples. Bharti, un chemin, un couple masculin, le soleil. Iris, un couple masculin, un pont. Victoria Posse, le brouillard, le pont, le phare. Ashley, le phare, attention, la promenade. Souvenez-vous, Ashley, the words ending with ad in most of the cases, they're feminine. And then, la foule, curiosidades, le pont, le chemin, le ciel. Irène, le phare, la rue, le ciel. Hope Johnson, la femme féminin, un homme, le ciel peut-être. Songcrod, bonjour, participez s'il vous plaît. Ensuite, Lunique, le point, est-ce que c'est le pont, P-O-N-T, les gens et un phare. Olga Ruiz, l'homme et la femme. Attention, homme with an H in front of the O. Bickert, un phare, le ciel et la brume. Victoria Jacques, les gens, un peu d'eau. Très bien. Mujahid, la tour, les couples et le tunnel. Sundar, la longue rue, les couples, le chemin. Maria Bethania, des personnes, le phare et le pont. Ensuite, Save the Best, un homme, une femme, des gens, un ciel, la rue. Je suis Lani, les gens, attention pluriel, la promenade, la passerelle. Rory, mec, c'est comme bro en anglais. Oui, bro, dude, mais faites vraiment attention. It means that Rory, I mean, be really careful with this word. You really don't want to use it in all the situations. So, as usual, as I say, Rory, be aware about the context first, and after that, you can adapt. It's totally okay to use them, these words, but still, you need to be aware if the context is allowing that or not. I just call des couples le coucher de soleil une rue, oui. Stéphanie, l'homme et la femme. La tour, son crode, un homme, les gens, le soleil. Très bien. Corinne, why am I watching this? Zero, zero. I don't know, Corinne Robinson. I mean, it's nice to watch me. Thank you very much. Allez, let's go for the next one. Alors, as you know, every day we try to cover a verb, and in that case, we're talking about the conjugation. Conjugation is extremely important. So this is the reason why we will try now to concentrate. I wanted to pick a pronominal verb, se présenter. Remember, se présenter means that you will have to use some pronouns, because se will have to change. So the way it will go, because normally when we're talking about reaching this advanced level, it means mastering indicatif, all the tenses that you can see, conditionnel, and then subjonctif. So these are the tenses that normally you should master to be advanced. But for us, in that case, because this is intermediate level, we'll focus on présent de l'indicatif, futur simple, passé composé, imparfait, plus que parfait, and then conditionnel présent. So we're talking about six tenses in that situation. Okay? So the way it will go, look, I will basically, and we'll start with the present of the indicative, and I will ask you the je form. S'il vous plaît, please give me first affirmative and then negative form for this verb se présenter indicatif présent. Now you can go. Thank you. Alors, apparently you didn't want to give me the negative form. Well, it's okay, because I will put the negative form just on my own. Alors, first, affirmative form, je me présente. And so that's the reason why we call it verbe pronominal, because you have to use some pronouns. So, je me, and then remember that me will have to be right before your verb. Je me présente. Then the negative form, and that's the reason why I wanted you to go for the negative form too, because as you can see, you start the subject je. Then you consider that this relationship, this couple, pronoun me, and then the verb présente, you don't put anything between the two. So it means that your negative form will come before and after this couple, this unit. Je, subject. First part of the negative form, ne. Then you put your pronoun and your verb, me présente, and you finish with pas. Je ne me présente pas. So let's now please have a look at futur simple. Exactly the same thing, please. Could you write me the two forms affirmative and negative form of se présenter in the future simple for je. Merci beaucoup. Alors, I'm looking at your forms, and so far so good. I mean, we agree that the idea here was to put, well, the future simple form. So, if we really want to say it, I mean, it's not really tricky because the verb in itself is quite easy to conjugate and to put in the future tense because it's présenterai. I mean, it's a classic thing. You keep the infinitive and you put the ending AI. Don't forget, of course, the pronoun me. Je me présenterai. And then it's the same thing when it goes for the negative form. I mean, as we had previously, you don't put anything between your pronoun and the verb. So it means that your negative form will come before and after je. First part of the negative form. Ne, then me présenterai, and you finish with pas. Je ne me présenterai pas. D'accord? So that's it. Sundar is asking if présenter is a reflexive verb. Yes, it is. I tend to use another term. The term is pronominal verb because it's a bit wider. I mean, we'll see that in this pronominal verbs category, we've got different things, and reflexive verbs is one of them. But yes, to answer simple in a simple manner to you, Sundar, yeah, it's a pronominal verb and then reflexive verb in that case, which is a subcategory of it. And it's true that you need to keep in mind one big thing, and the big thing is to click on the like, because I can see that there are 80 persons right now and I've got only 39 likes. So it's not really serious. You should click on the like, thank you very much. And then we can, and we will continue because we're here to study some things. So let's look now at passé composé. Passé composé, it's the first compound tense of our list. So let's have a look at passé composé form for se présenter. Same thing. I would like the two forms. So I want affirmative form and negative form, please. Alors, Daria join us. Bonsoir Daria, and thank you for inviting people to like the video. So, let's have a look at the form. So, we agree that se présenter, because it's a pronominal verb, then in that case, it means that when we talk about the compound tenses, we'll have to use être as a helping verb. So, je... And then you put, once again, the pronoun me. Je me suis présenté. Remember that the rule is simple. If you use être, then you have to put at the end of your présenté, so the past participle, whether the feminine, if it's feminine, or then the plural, if it's plural, or the feminine plural, if it's feminine plural. In that situation, we don't really know if it's masculine or feminine, so we'll put the option of the feminine. You don't pronounce it, yet you need to write it if it's feminine. Okay, so, and then for the negative form, so let's have a look because it's a tricky thing, negative structure in compound tenses. Look at the way it goes. Now you can see that your pronoun me will be connected to suis. So it means that your negative form won't interfere, it won't come between the two. So you start with je. After that, you will start, I mean, the first part of the negative form, ne. Then you will put me suis, and then your pas is coming right after your helping verb, pas présenté. You finish with the past participle. Je ne me suis pas présenté. This is, well, I would say it's between intermediate to advanced, because it's quite tricky. People tend to make some mistakes with the order, but the order is quite strict, so that's the reason why I wanted to put different colors, so that you can visualize, I mean, what should go where. Okay, so it was passé composé. Let's have a look at imparfait. Imparfait, exactly the same thing. Could you give me the affirmative and negative form? Alors, I can see that Ankan is the first, but unfortunately, Ankan, you've been giving another tense, you've been giving the conditionnel présent. Sapna is giving us the proper tense. So, verb présenter, or then se présenter, but présenter, it's présentait. Okay, so se présenter, same thing, we'll have to use the pronoun, so me, so same structure, in that case, it's a simple tense, so it means that you don't have any helping verb. Je, then you put your pronoun me, and then you go for présenter, je me présentais. Negative form, like we had previously for the simple tenses, je ne me présentais pas. D'accord? Je me présentais, je ne me présentais pas. Don't be sad, Ankan. It happens. It's okay to make mistakes. I mean, this is how you learn, in fact. Allez, let's have a look at the second tense, second compound tense of the list. It's plus que parfait. Plus que parfait, same thing. Affirmative and negative, please. Alors, I can see that you start to give me your things. Yonu Kang, say, je suis un élève de sixième. Bonjour, bonjour Yonu. You can participate. We're doing some conjugation right now. And it was the plus que parfait form of se présenter. Look at it. So, je m'étais présenté. So, we agree that it's a compound tense, plus que parfait. Means that we will use être because it's a pronominal verb. Être will be in the imparfait form. Je étais. And then we put, of course, the pronoun before. We put the apostrophe because it starts with the vowel. Était. Je m'étais présenté. Negative form. Exactly the same concept as we had for the passé composé. For the position of the negative form. Je, then ne, first part of the negative form, m'étais, and then we close with the second part of the negative form, pas, and you finish with your past participle présenté. Je ne m'étais pas présenté. Don't forget the pas. Victoria Posse has been forgetting the pas. But it's okay. Don't worry. Little by little, the bird builds its nest. Comme on dit en français, Victoria Posse, petit à petit, l'oiseau fait son nid. Hein, les choses prennent du temps. C'est normal. OK, let's have a look now at conditionnel présent. Please, conditionnel présent, affirmative and negative form. Alors, I'm looking at the first forms that are already arriving. So, when it comes to se présenter, I mean to conjugate that in a conditionnel présent, it's not really tricky because it's présenterait. Then, we, of course, need to use the pronoun me, hein, again. Je me présenterai. Remember, ending A-I-S. And then, because it's a simple tense for the negative form, it's exactly as we had previously. Je, then you put ne, first part of the negative form, me présenterai, and you finish with the pas. Je ne me présenterai pas. Merci beaucoup. So I know it can be extremely intense to do the conjugation. So I'm sorry about that, but it's really necessary to conjugate. And especially in that case, I mean, the pronominal verbs, is, you know, with the negative form, it's always challenging, always challenging. So we need to practice again and again. And now it's the picture of the day because you love, I mean, you probably know that I like pictures. So look at this one. Try to write a simple sentence to describe this photo. Merci beaucoup. the first one to write « J'adore » en Cannes. Il y a beaucoup de clés sur la table. D'accord, est-ce que vous êtes sûr que c'est la table? Ina, il y a beaucoup de clés et de papier sur la table. Passang, sur la table, il y a beaucoup de clés. Un stylo, probablement. Rory, des clés pour ouvrir quoi? Je ne sais pas. Et c'est ça la question, Rory. Qu'est-ce que c'est que ces clés, hein? This is the mystery. We don't know what they're for. Sundar, je vois beaucoup de clés sur la table. Yossi, les clés sont dispersées sur la table. Très bien écrit, Yossi. Songkrod, je vois plusieurs clés dans cette photo. Et c'est vrai. Huan, il y a beaucoup de clés et une carte, un crayon masculin sur la table. Iris, un homme organise ses clés sur la table. Très bien. Mujahid, c'est moi qui cherche mes clés. Les clés du succès. Ah, on cherche tous les clés du succès. Emma Chomao, il y a beaucoup de clés sur le sol. Eka, sur la table, il y a des clés, une feuille blanche et un crayon. Pourquoi Pourquoi is having some doubts regarding imparfait, conditionnel présent. Well, you're not the first one. Endings are the same, so this is the reason why it's a bit tricky. Ice cubes, il y a des clés partout. And then you show your tongue. Quoi? Stéphanie, elle a un morceau de papier avec quelques touches et un crayon. Steph, sur cette photo, il y a beaucoup de clés. Très bien. Sundar, aujourd'hui, j'ai perdu la clé de ma moto. C'est vrai? Oh, mais c'est terrible. Is it true? C'est vrai, Sundar? Sapna, je vois plusieurs clés sur la table. Carré, autour d'un papier et d'un crayon. Crayon, attention, Sapna, you write it C-R-A-Y-O-N. Alexei, il y a beaucoup de choses sur le plancher. Très bien écrit, Alexei. Bickert, je vois plusieurs matériaux avec des choses utiles sur la table. Cette chambre est très sombre. Eh oui. I just called, il y a des pieds. Beaucoup de clés sur l'étage, un stylo et du papier. Pradip, il y a beaucoup de clés et un crayon. Curiosidades, il y a beaucoup de clés sur le sol. Peut-être que cela nous mènera vers un trésor ou un lieu mystérieux rempli d'escargots, probablement. Maria Betania, cet homme ne sait pas quelle clé utiliser pour ouvrir l'armoire. Oui, Olga Ruiz. Mais non, Olga, you should write in French. Sandra, il y a des chaussures sur la table. Mais oui, c'est bizarre, hein. Ouria, il y a beaucoup de clés et un crayon au milieu et un papier. Quelqu'un va voler un supermarché. Je suis la niche. Il y a un trousseau de clés par terre. Et Sundar qui dit oui, oui, c'est vrai. Oh, mais c'est terrible. Sundar a perdu les clés de sa moto aujourd'hui. Alors ça n'est pas très, très amusant. Alors, the idea is to focus on the how to translate type of exercises, and now we will focus on le passé composé. So I'm hoping you to translate all the sentences that I will give you in English, and then you translate them into, French, obviously, but then with the passé composé, okay? So I hope you're ready. And this is the first one. The first one is, I told him the truth. I told him the truth. How could you translate that into French using, please, le passé composé? Thank you. Alors, in that case, I was hoping you to use the verb dire in the passé composé form, so it's j'ai dit. But once again, you know that I want always to get you ready to use the pronoun, so I'm putting the pronoun. And the pronoun should come before your helping verb, and it's avoir in that case, so je, lui, so lui, because it's complément d'objet indirect, hein. Je lui ai dit la vérité. So what I can see that you're writing it extremely properly. Look, if you've got the accents on your keyboard, that vérité should be with two accent aigus, okay. But then for the others, it's quite good. Be careful with D-I-T, the past participle, le participe passé. So, number two, numéro deux. Et numéro deux, oh non, this is not the passé composé. Why do I put that? It's strange. Numéro trois. It's a technical thing. Hein? Voilà. Numéro trois, I made pancakes. Alors, Ina is asking if I could explain for the COD and COE. The tricky thing, Ina, is that these lives are for exercises, so they're not for lessons per se. I've been making lots of videos, and trust me, I explained that quite thoroughly in the videos. So in these situations right now, we're doing exercises, so this is the reason why it's difficult to take the time to explain that, because it's a big topic and it takes some time to explain that. So I made pancakes. So pancakes, of course, Lunik is asking, how can you translate pancakes in French? Well, you would go for, I guess, crepe in first. Of course, pancakes are not really crepe, but it's a bit, it's almost the same. So you can go for pancake if you want to pronounce it like that, but go for crepe. Crepe, you know, you've got different versions of crepe, so I think it could work. But anyways, the idea was to use here the verb faire. We put the passé composé, so the compound tense, passé composé, j'ai fait, because we use it with the helping verb avoir. J'ai, past participle, it's fait, F-A-I-T, j'ai fait, and then you continue with crêpe. Alors crêpe, ideally you put accent circonflexe, and in that case, because you pronounce it. Alors let's have a look at number four, numéro quatre, oui. Set the table. We set the table. Let's agree that it should be in the passé composé form. Alors, this is interesting. The expression to set the table in French, it's mettre la table. Mettre la table. So basically, we use the verb mettre. Remember that when it comes to mettre, if we want to put this verb in the passé composé form, so helping verb will be avoir, and then past participle will be mis, M-E-S. So we, normally we should go for nous avons mis la table. I can see that Ice Cubes wanted to put the on a mis la table, which is totally correct. It's exactly the same thing, but of course, as you did, you need to conjugate it according to the on third person of the singular. So, on a mis la table is totally correct. Nous avons mis la table. Well, let's say that it's the classical way to express this oui in French. Allez, let's look at the last one, if it's correct. yes, you haven't left your home. You haven't left your home. How would it be in French with the passé composé? Alors, let's have a look at what you're writing and let me laugh because Ice Cube is saying, ouais, je suis comme les jeunes. Well, yeah. Alors, attention. So, I was personally, one second, because of course the machine is like it is. Tu n'es pas sorti de chez toi. So of course, when you go for the you, when you translate that in French, it could be vous, or then it could be tu. So now, I wanted to put tu here, just like that, but it could be vous, no problem. Let's agree that sortir, because this is the verb that we want to use, sortir is conjugated with être. So tu es sorti. Remember, because we're using être, we'll have to put as an option the feminine form e. D'accord? You don't pronounce it, still it should be there. Tu es sorti. Then we'll insert the negation. So the negative form is before and after your helping verb. Tu n'es, and then you put the second part, pas sorti. D'accord? This is the thing that might be tricky. I mean, all the time, I mean, people tend to make some mistakes with that. So, tu ne es. And then, will have to disappear. So, apostrophe, tu n'es, second part, pas, and then sorti, and the rest, de chez toi. Remember that your home, of course, we can use ta maison, but in fact, ta maison refers really to a house, a building, a house. It cannot be used for an apartment. So if you really want to use this general home concept, go for the preposition chez and after that toi. Chez moi, chez toi, chez lui, chez elle, chez nous, chez vous, chez eux, chez elle. Voilà, tu n'es pas sorti de chez toi. And so what about talking about you for a change? The three verbs of your life. And I'm talking about verbs. I'm not talking about nouns. I'm not talking about adverbs or adjectives. I am talking about verbs. Could you please write three verbs that could define you the best? Allez, take 1 minute to write that and we'll see that together. Thank you. I can see that there are many questions arriving. Mujahid, is that passé composé or plus que parfait? So I think you were referring to the previous one. It was passé composé. Tu es parti. It was passé composé. Curiosidades was asking pourquoi de chez toi and pas chez toi? Well, because the verb partir, partir de. And then you put the place. Okay, so that's the reason why. Partir de chez moi. This is the reason why. Sapna, is it an advice or is it... No, it's not an advice in that case. It was definitely this passé composé, the past concept. Alors, let's look now. Alors, Ankan is saying, telling us that the three verbs that would define him or her better, it's se réveiller, manger and dormir. Bickert, se regarder, s'habiller, se tenir. Et Machomao, manger, dormir, s'endormir. Passang, regarder, poser, dabou. What do you want to say with dabou? I don't understand Passang, because dabou, it's not a verb, in fact. Lunique, apprendre, penser, aimer. Rory, peindre, jouer, chanter. Curiosidades, tenir, couvrir, regarder. Mujahid, travailler, payer des taxes et se reposer en paix. Ah, le classique, monsieur. Alors, ensuite, Irène nous dit merci beaucoup, Vincent, bonne nuit. It's already 11 p.m. here in the Philippines. Well, have a good night, Irene, if you're going to bed. Rita, sourire, manger, apprendre. Victoria, Jacques, cacher, supporter, tenir. Kevin, travailler et travailler. OK. Yana, étudier, écouter, apprendre. Ice Cubes, se cacher, refléter, tenir. Iris, gentille. Yeah, be careful, Iris, because gentille is not it's not a verb. Être gentil, it could be. Aimer, sourire. Daria, améliorer, étudier, s'organiser. Olga, faire. Attention, Olga, faire. F-A-I-R-E. Rêver. E-R, lire. Yossi, apprendre, voyager, lire. Maria Bethania, aimer, enseigner, réussir. Eka, manger, dormir et jouer. Victoria Possé, apprendre, lire et faire du sport. Sapna, réfléchir. It's not a reflexive verb, hein, Sapna. This réfléchir. Hein. Apprendre and chercher. Marc, manger, être gentil, to be nice, travailler. Je suis Lani, lire, écouter, travailler. I just called, penser, étudier, aider. Très bien. Save the best, attendre et attendre. Ah, vous êtes patiente. C'est une qualité. Stéphanie, lire, apprendre le français, cuisiner et dormir. CRB. Manager, travailler, habiter. OK. Sans crode, cacher, avoir et habiller. OK. Daria qui dit « Don't forget to like ». Oh, Daria. Alors, Daria, if you insist. And Daria is insisting, so I need to press on the button. Please, click on the like. Thank you very much. It could be really, really nice. Allez, merci beaucoup en tout cas. Alors, so you probably understood that today the concept is a bit thematical because the idea is to make you translate things. And in that case, we will, and I'm hoping you to use in the sentence that you make, the conditionnel présent. And then I would like you to go for the vous, because when we translate, if in English it's you, we don't really know whether to go for tu or then for vous. In that case, it would be really nice if you could use only vous. Let's not go for tu, let's go for vous, because the forms are a bit more challenging sometimes. Okay, so let's go for vous, and then we can start right now if you want. Let's have a look at the first one, and the first one is could you answer me? Conditionnel présent, and vous, go for it, please. Alors, you know that I want to test your limits all the time because I think that this is the best way to learn the language. So, of course, it's a tricky one. It is a tricky one because the verb is pouvoir. And pouvoir, when you go for the conditionnel, then the root is changing. The root will be pour. P-O-U-R-R. Then this is your root. You know that the ending for vous should be I-E-Z. You combine the two and you will get pourriez. Pourriez. And then after that you put the vous. I'm putting these forms because of course it's always good to start with the correct way to use the language. And after that you can play with it. So, of course, you could destructure it, you could change it, no problem. But this is normally the correct way to ask somebody something. So, pourriez-vous me répondre? D'accord? Pourriez-vous me répondre? This is the proper way to ask somebody to answer to you. And then, in fact, we're using, in that case, as you can see, conditionnel présent with the vous form. Let's have a look at the second one. And the second one is, would you like a cup of coffee? Would you like a cup of coffee? Remember, translation into French with conditionnel présent and vous form. Let's be polite. Alors, same thing here, because as you know, I want us to explore all the difficulties of the language. So the verb is vouloir. And then we want to put vouloir in the conditionnel present tense. So it means that the root will change. And it will be voudre. So V-O-U-D-R. This is the root. After that, we'll add the ending I-E-Z, and so you end up with this form, voudriez, voudriez. So, Ancan is asking, can we use aimeriez? Of course you can, oui. Aimeriez would be totally acceptable, Ancan. Kevin has been going for aimeriez, it's totally possible. I went for voudriez because it's a bit more challenging for the construction, but if you want to go with aimeriez, no problem at all. Alors, let's go for it. Voudriez. And then, because we are using this polite form, we put the subject after. Voudriez-vous. And we continue. I mean, the rest is not really challenging. Une tasse de café. Don't forget the accent aigu on café. It would be nicer. So, voudriez-vous une tasse de café. This is really polite. This is the polite way to ask for, or then in that case, to offer a cup of coffee. D'accord? Alors, let's have a look at numéro 3. Alors, before that, Yossi is asking, could we say prendriez-vous? Yes, of course. But in that case, Yossi, it's just... if you say prendriez-vous somehow, it's working, but I need to visualize the cup of coffee. So it's like the difference, it's a subtle difference, but still, you see, I've got the feeling that you've got the cup of coffee in your hand, and then you're offering it to the person. Whereas this voudriez-vous, you don't really need to visualize it right away. Well, it's subtle, but then... To answer your question, you see, yes, you can do it. Numéro 3. Numéro 3, would you have time? Would you have time? Same thing, please. Conditionnel présent and then vous form. Alors, here, yes. So remember that the expression, it's avoir le temps. Avoir le temps. So this expression can be, of course, I mean, after that, declined in all the tenses. So in that situation, we want to use it in the conditionnel présent tense. We all know that avoir, it's a tricky one. It's a tricky one because basically the root will change. The root will become or, A-U-R. Then you will put the ending, I-E-Z, that we had. You combine the two, it's auriez, auriez. Then after that we put vous, auriez-vous, and then we finish with le temps. Auriez-vous le temps? Well, in most of the cases, you put something after, of course. Auriez-vous le temps de venir avec moi? Auriez-vous le temps de prendre un café? Etc, etc. But then in that case, it's just to work on this simple expression. Auriez-vous le temps? Rory is saying zero correct, but you're still... And that's the spirit, Rory. Rory, you've got a fighter spirit, and this is the best way to do it. You will fight and you will succeed. Don't worry about that. I mean, it's good to make mistakes. This is the only way to really understand the thing. And after that, you will make less and less mistakes. No worries, Rory. I trust you and I believe in you. Numéro 4, regardez, would you be interested in my proposal? Proposal would be like an offer. Hein? Would you be interested in my offer? Would you be interested in my proposal? How would you translate that in conditionnel présent with vous? Alors, regardons ici. As you know, sometimes I like to give you some easy exercises and sometimes I like to give you some more challenging one. And this one is a bit challenging, I admit that. So, let's look at, the translation. Of course, you can see that probably now on your screen. The expression is être intéressé. Être intéressé. And then after that, you go for par. And then you continue. So, the only thing that we will have to really work on will be être. So, être, well, it's a tricky one too, because the root will change. It will become sœur, S-E-R. Then you will put the ending, I-E-Z, seriez. So, seriez is, in fact, the conditionnel present form of être. Seriez-vous, then you continue with your intéressé par ma proposition. Seriez-vous intéressé par ma proposition? So this is extremely, these structures, I wanted to really give us the possibility to explore this, really correct way of asking things. So after that, there are many, many ways to ask things, but this is the proper way. Lunik is asking, is it the conditionnel passé? Non, Lunik. In fact, if you really want to look at it, it's what we call passif conditionnel passé. So basically, it's the passive form of intéressé in the conditionnel présent, because this is the way it goes, remember? Well, we've been working on the passif, but the passif is to introduce être, and then you will have to put être in the different tenses. In that case, you can see that être is in the conditionnel présent, so this is the passive conditionnel présent. Alors, Yossi is asking, avoir or être sœur, what is the logic? There is no logic, Yossi. You could even add to your list, aller will become ir. So it means that all these roots, well, after that, Yossi, it's another trip. The trip would be to go in with the etymology of the thing, and then you could see that, for instance, aller and ir, we get some close relationship to Spanish, for instance. Huh? So, but it's another story. So it means that all these roots, I mean, will be different. You just need to learn them by heart. This is the best way to do it. If you don't want to go, I mean, the long way, you could go for the etymology, but I'm not sure if it will help everybody right away. But anyway, so let's have a look at the number five now. Number five, would you like to attend the meeting? Please, conditionnel présent and vous form. No, ice cubes. No. It's the French logic, the most beautiful one. Alors, so let's take the time. So some of you went for a souhaiteriez, voudriez, I can accept that. I wanted in that case to go for souhaiteriez. Aimeriez would be totally acceptable. So let's look at it. I mean, the idea, of course, is to use souhaiter, aimer, vouloir. And then you go for the conditionnel présent form, so voudriez, aimeriez, or then in my case, souhaiteriez. After that, you will put your vous right after, because it's like it's a formal question. Let's do it nice. Souhaiteriez, vous, voudriez, vous, aimeriez, vous. Be careful, Mark, because the idea was to use the vous form. The idea was really to make it formal. After that, we can play with it, we can destructure, we can use the tu, we can change it. But now we want to make it really proper, to make it sure that we understand how to make it. So first the verb, souhaiteriez, then vous, and then you continue, so participer à la réunion. Be careful, in French, we don't use attendre. Attendre in French, it's really to wait. Attendre, it's not to attend. At all, it's to wait. So it's like a false friend that we have in French and in English. To attend a meeting, in French, it's participer à une réunion. If you go for attendre, I've got the feeling that you're waiting for somebody or something. It's really the waiting concept in French. And yes, Ice Cubes is challenging me with the logic of French language. And there is a logic. There is a logic. Difficult to transmit from time to time, but still there is one. It's the French logic. So now let's go for the three verbs of the day. So as you know, I mean, I like to offer you a picture and try to look at the picture and find me three verbs. Please write the verbs in the infinitive form, okay? So, three verbs connected to this interesting picture. Merci beaucoup. Alors, passant was extremely fast. Jouer, faire and attendre. Yossi's right after. Marcher, se promener, regarder. Son crotte, jouer, respirer, rouler. Mr. Peter, patiner, divertir. Yeah, Mr. Peter, go for se divertir. Hein, se divertir, faire du sport. Sundar, faire du ski. Are you sure? Se tenir debout, courir. Daria, fixer un regard. Faire du skating. Non, Daria. Alors ça, c'est un anglicisme brutal. Faire du patin ou faire du patinage. Profiter de l'hiver. Skier, patiner. Ok. Yana, rechercher, regarder. Être perdu, peut-être, ou se perdre. Rory, faire du ski. Sentir le froid, courir. Omia, jouer, se promener, très bien. Lunik, faire du patin à glace. Faire. Regarder et attendre. Juan, jouer et fêter. Curiosidades, marcher, regarder. Faire du patin ou patiner. Profiter, attendre, jouer, respirer. Très inspiré, Curiosidades. Victoria Jacques, patiner, regardez, très bien. Pourroi, jouer, participer. Mohana Devi, localiser, se tenir debout et courir. Maria Bethania, geler, jouer, patiner, très bien. YouTube Browser, patiner, très bien. CRB, promener. Ouais, se promener, ce serait plus... probablement meilleur, hein, it would be better, travailler and jouer. Sapna, voir, attendre, tomber de la neige. Oui, d'accord. Bickert, s'amuser, patiner, faire le tour de la piste. Iris, faire du patinage ou faire du patin, jouer. Pradip qui dit « Oh là là !» Mais Pradip, « Oh là là !» ce n'est pas un verbe. Je suis Lani, patiner, regarder, neiger. Toufik, patiner, être debout ou se tenir debout et jouer. Eka nous propose, balancer. Alors, la dictée, it's the dictation of the day. As you know, every day we are seeing some sentences. We'll see four sentences, so I will read them two times. So you have to listen to them quite carefully. I will read them, you write them, and we'll see if you don't make any mistakes. Alors, on y va. I will try to not to press on the wrong button this time. So let's see. Four sentences, as you know. The first one, one second, because I need to adjust my thing. And it's good now. I hope you're ready. I will read it twice, d'accord? And then you need to write it. C'est l'arbre que j'avais planté il y a 5 ans. C'est l'arbre que j'avais planté il y a 5 ans. So try to write the sentence. Alors, in that case, I wanted to introduce the plus que parfait. So I wanted you to work on the plus que parfait of the verb planter. As you can see, it's j'avais planté. D'accord? So the first part, it's not really tricky because it's c'est, after that you introduce l'arbre, que, but then it was the tricky thing, but then so far, be careful, j'avais planté, hein, we agree that it's, yeah, it should be participe passé, planté with the accent. I'm looking at your things at the same time, c'est the best, be careful, it was planté with the accent, because it's j'avais planté, hein. The full thing, j'avais planté, it's this plus que parfait, you know, the past in the past, hein, j'avais planté. C'est l'arbre que j'avais planté il y a 5, alors normally you write it quite correctly, 5, yeah, whether with the letters or then with the numbers, but it's okay. Oh, so that was the first one. Second one, let's take the time to discover it. One little second. Wow. C'est bon. Nous devrions leur en parler. Nous devrions leur en parler. Allez-y, écrivez la phrase. Alors, attention, nous devrions, so of course I wanted to go once again in the conditionnel présent, so it's the verb devoir, and the verb devoir, when you will put it in the conditionnel présent, then in that case it will be devre plus the ending, nous devrions leur en parler. So of course I wanted to introduce as usual some pronouns before your infinitive here. So leur, l-e-u-r, en, and then parler. Nous devrions leur en parler. Remember that the last verb, parler, should definitely be in the infinitive form, because it's the second verb and the first one, devrions, is conjugated. So, your parler form should be definitely er, infinitive form. So, let's go for... one second, because Yossi is asking, pourriez-vous prononcer c'est and ce? Okay. So, it's just for Yossi. And so... let's agree on that. First one, if you look at what Yossi wrote, he's been writing first, c'est, and then the second one, he's been writing ce. So basically, Yossi, and I remember that you've been talking about that, but then I've been skipping it because I was in my thing. So the main difference between the two will be the difference between est and okay, so here, first one will be c'est, second one will be ce. And so I remember, Yossi, that you were talking about les and le. We could extend it to des and de. So it's really the difference between the est really open and clearly. Well, let me help you with that. One second, I'm here. So the thing is that when you make this eh sound, you really open the mouth. Eh, it must be open. You can see that basically it goes like a trompette. Hein? It doesn't need to be extremely, extremely open. Okay, this is the reason why we're making this new series with the pronunciation. This is the reason why, monsieur. Okay, so that's the way it goes. So let's have a look now, if you want, at the next one. Number three. And so, of course, I will read it for you and I hope that you will write it. Numéro 3, on y va. Il n'a pas pu prendre le bus car il était en retard. Il n'a pas pu prendre le bus car il était en retard. In that situation, well, we agree that I wanted to go for the passé composé of pouvoir. Il n'a pas pu. So this is the verb pouvoir, and then you put that in the passé composé form. Il n'a pas pu. The rest, well, obviously, infinitive form, because it's coming right after the first verb that is conjugated. So prendre. Le bus, and of course I wanted to play a bit with the imparfait form, il était. Remember, for the ending of était, it should be a-i-t. Okay, third person of the singular, il était. Hein? So I wanted to play with the passé composé and then imparfait, because it's usually something that, well, I mean, students, they tend to struggle a bit with. So, il n'a pas pu prendre le bus car il était en retard. Allez, let's have a look at number four. Number four, one second, I'm just clicking and scrolling like that. On y va. Il rentrera directement chez lui après le travail. Il rentrera directement chez lui après le travail. Alors, it seems that you love the future simple tense, hein? Le futur simple. Apparently, it's quite okay with you. So, basically, I wanted, in that case, to put futur simple of rentrer. So, rentrer will give you, il rentrera. Okay. After that, of course, I wanted to inject a little adverb, directement. Exactement. Remember the way we construct these adverbs? It's starting with the adjective. So direct masculine form ends with T. You go with the feminine form, direct with the E. And after that, you add the ment. Directement. Il rentrera directement chez lui, of course, because I want to insist on the chez lui, après le travail. Alors Ice Cube dit oui parce que c'est simple. I don't buy that. Alors, Ice Cube, she's been saying that it's simple. Mais non, c'est pas simple. C'est pas simple, especially the passé simple. Well, I mean, we know that passé simple is not simple. So now the next one is, what is she thinking about? So what is she thinking about? Look at this interesting picture. Elle pense à quoi? À quoi pense-t-elle? Une phrase, give me one sentence and tell me what she is thinking about. Alors, Mr. Peter is the first one to say elle pense au féminisme dans le monde. Yeah, it's quite interesting, Mr. Peter, because all the words with this ism will be masculine. So it means that with le, remember, it will give you elle pense au féminisme dans le monde. M&M 19, elle pense à la revanche. Let's get back to them. They will suffer. Kafilat, elle pense que les filles gouvernent le monde. Olga Ruiz, elle pense qu'elle est très forte. Très bien. EK, elle pense au pouvoir des femmes. Ice Cubes, elle pense qu'elle a écrit sur le miroir. Miroir masculin, Ice Cubes, le. Ensuite, Lanora, elle pense à l'égalité. Très bien. All About Lies, elle pense au féminisme. Yossi, elle se demande si la couleur du... Comment ça? Lipstick, c'est rouge à lèvres, monsieur. Rouge à lèvres, lui ira bien. Stardust, pourquoi j'utilise mon meilleur rouge à lèvres pour écrire ceci? Iris, elle a pensé à son mari. Ok. Daria, elle pense à son pouvoir. Rory, elle pense que le rouge à lèvres est comme le crayon. C'est pour écrire, mais ce n'est pas vrai. Bickert, elle pense que je dois avoir le pouvoir, comme toujours, parce que je suis une femme. Oui. I just called, elle pense, ne me sous-estime pas. Eh ben oui. Yana, elle pense qu'elle est belle. Yep, remember that you should put the apostrophe on k. Hein? Q-U apostrophe, qu'elle est belle. And then you put être, elle est belle. YouTube browser, elle ne pense pas maintenir le miroir. Ok? I'm not sure I get this one. Songcrod, elle pense qu'un jour elle deviendra plus forte. Yep, Songcrod, you should put the forte in the feminine form. Yo, Mohana, elle pense encourager sa confiance par chaque action. Très bien écrit. Really well written, Mohana. Looney, elle pense que les filles sont fortes quand son rouge à lèvres tombe dans l'évier. Non! Juan, elle pense qu'on peut faire ce que les hommes ne peuvent pas. And that's probably true. And it's not probably, it's for sure. Bourville Lover, elle pense au pouvoir des femmes qui la rendent fière. All About Life, elle se sent forte d'être féministe, maybe, ou femme, I don't know. Sapna, elle pense devenir une avocate après faire une loi où les filles ont tous plus de pouvoir que les hommes. Sundar, elle pense que les femmes sont plus puissantes que les hommes. D'accord. Pradeep, elle rentre directement chez lui après le travail. Pradeep, you're not synchronized. Pradeep, refresh your page. Curiosidades, elle pense que les femmes doivent être appréciées et non discriminées. Car il y a eu des femmes qui ont contribué à l'humanité, l'humanité comme Marie Curie. And we've been talking about Marie Curie and many other, at least French-speaking women here. Toufik, elle pense au féminisme. Ice Cubes, tous les ismes sont masculins, n'est-ce pas? Pourquoi le féminisme doit être le féminisme? Non, 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 féminisme is masculine, le féminisme. Ice Cubes, the words in ism are masculine, so it is logical in that case. Ice Cubes, she wants to push the limits of the logic of French language. Well, French people are a bit logical. Let's agree that please don't start right now because I need to take my notepad because I want to make it fair for everybody. So this is the way it will go. Remember how it goes because it is extremely important to make it fair for everyone. So I've got my notepad here, as you can see. I've got my pen here, so I will write a number. So let me explain to you at the same time. I will think and I will write a number from 1 to 100. Then you will write one and only one number, that is obviously from 1 to 1. It's going too fast now. To 100, and then the winner of the thing will get an access for not the beginners, because in that case it will be the intermediate. Courses in my platform. Okay, so this is the way it will go. Now I am putting a number right there. One second. Hopla, that's it. I hope you're ready because now we can start. So give me a number from 1 to 100. Thank you. Well, once again, it's like every 2 days, apparently. This is the way it goes. Nobody found my incredible number. Nobody! So now we can start a second round. Try to find my number, please. Incroyable, incroyable. It's incredible, it's incredible. So let's agree on that. I mean, people are trying to, well, let's narrow the thing just to make sure that everyone have a chance. Voilà. No, like that. Third round, let's narrow it. It's from 1 to 50. Go for it now. Thank you. finalement, finalement, nous avons réussi à trouver le nombre. Et c'était Mr. Peter qui nous a proposé 29. Mr. Peter, est-ce que vous êtes avec nous encore? Et si vous êtes là, Mr. Peter, eh bien, tout le monde, parce que nous sommes très très gentils, nous sommes une communauté, une famille, nous allons vous féliciter. Bravo, bravo, Mr. Peter. Et voilà, Mr. Peter, c'est effectivement le héros du jour. Bravo, bravo en tout cas. So once again, the way it goes, you just register to the platform. And then on a platform, because I don't know if somebody was struggling with it, you can find a place to send me a message. But then don't worry, if you don't find it, I mean, tomorrow I will explain. I will give you an email address if you want. No worries. So you send me the message, Mr. Peter and the others, and then I will, of course, be so pleased to give you the access to, well, several courses, because I don't put, well, everything. I put a little on YouTube, but then the most, I mean, the main thing is on the platform. So there are really, really many, many things on the platform. So you can be sure that you will learn French and you will be successful in your French studies. But once again, Mr. Peter, congratulations. And so one more time, I just insist on the fact that we're starting the new series. So if you want to participate, and let's see if it will be successful or not, but still, I think it could be fun. So you record yourself with your phone, and then you can record the video or then just the audio. You pronounce the phrase, you send me that to pronounce at fluent2plus.com. Then after that, I will make a video with all your audio tracks and the video tracks, and the sentence of the week is: nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant. You take your time to pronounce it. You record it, you pronounce it two times. Don't go too fast to make sure that clearly I can listen to everything and then I can help you. You send that to pronounce at fluent2plus.com. And so, merci à tous. So it was the, well, it's the end. And then tomorrow we'll have the last lesson of the week. Or maybe we'll see, because I've got some plans, and it will be at 4. So I hope to see you there. It will be for the advanced level. So merci beaucoup. Have a great day, or then it can be the night. I don't know where you are, but it was really, really fun to enjoy and to have the lesson with you. Merci beaucoup.
Seist yksin Para ver quién cae de la A la maailma ja ne tahdo palata. Suurin ongelma on, ettei ole ongelmaa. Tarpeeksi soha, joka allen sinut musertaa. Me kyllisen reunan ja asetut roikkumaan niin. Et ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni. Ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni.